Hello, today I'm here with a new video and today I'm here with update number 2 on my loba year. And I will leave all videos I have regarding my loba up in the card so you can check them out if you want to. And I am trying to do like these update videos every third month. And it didn't go so great the first one because I did it in April. But now June is over, it's July. So I'm going to show you what I have bought, and just to take a little bit fast with my low buy, I maybe can do that. I am buying 3 items per month, and if I only buy 1 item, say in June, I can buy 5 in July. So I always move them. So the first 4 months I didn't buy a lot of things, so in April, in the end of April, I splurged a little and also, yeah, but I am still on track. That's the most important thing. So I have bought a lot of eye stuff and 1 face stuff. And regarding my skincare, I haven't cheated with my skincare. I have only bought new things when things I have is over. And also in June, I didn't buy any new makeup. No makeup at all. I only bought skincare, but no makeup. So I had a no buy in June, and I'm actually pretty proud of myself. Maybe that sounds strange to say, but I did it. I did 1 month without buying any makeup. I am going to show you what I have bought, and we can start with the face thing. And I've bought Nip and Fab Fix Stick Definition. It's a contour stick for Nip and Fab, and this is in Cool 2 Taupe. It looks like this. I wanted to try cream contour. I'm still not good at it, so I haven't used this that much. And also now it's so freaking hot, I don't want to have even more creamy and sticky things on my face, so I haven't used this that much, but I will. The times I've used it, I like it, so it is an okay product. And then I also bought a bundle from ColourPop with all their creme gel liner, and yes, this I counted as 1 item. It was a bundle, and I love these. I have used them so much. I use them almost every time I do my makeup. These are fun color. These are more normal colors. It's a black and white and like a darker brown and the nude and stuff like that. So I have really been loving these. These are my absolute favorite colorful pens. I love my Linda Hallbergs, but these are so good. So I am so happy that I bought these. Another thing I bought from ColourPop was the Just My Luck palette. I can leave my first impression up here. I love this palette. This is their green palette. So I bought this as well. And now this is turning out a little haul. But it is like a haul. So really happy that I bought this. I was so... First I was like, I'm not going to buy it. Then I saw video after video and it seemed amazing. And I don't have that many green palettes. So I thought like, I can buy this. So I bought this. And then I also bought the Spectral palette from Linda Hallberg. It is her like pastel palette. I like this very much. I haven't used it that much. I don't really know why, but it doesn't feel like you want to see videos with this palette. So I think it's a little bit because of that I haven't used it. But this abstract shade, amazing. And I did change my rules after the first 3 months and didn't exclude Linda Hallberg, so this I counted as an item just with all the other stuff. Then this is mine now. This is the Melt Love 6 Stack. I have wanted this for a while. Bought it on Beauty Base sale. I can show you the colors while I'm talking. And I like this one. Oh, I put my finger in the shadow. I like this one, but I think I like the radioactive more. But I really wanted this. It was on sale and I was like, I have items left to buy this month. So I bought it. And then we can go into the best two things that I have bought, and that is the Kaleidos Makeup Futurism collection. These three palettes are three of my absolute favorite palettes ever. I love them so much. So I bought these, have done videos on all, have done a review, and these are amazing palettes, and I am so happy that I decided to buy them. I am not... Okay, I can take that when I've showed everything. And then the last thing is the Flare palette from Ace Beauté. I have waiting so long for this to come to Beauty Bay, and I think it sold out the first or the second day. It looks like this. I love this palette. Such good palette. I really love it. So how am I feeling about this low buy? It feels good. It feels great even. I think it's not hard now. It has been like my normal... I don't want to say that I've changed my mindset, but it was like when I've done 5 months, I was like, I can't fuck this up now. I can't. So now it's like, I want to fix this. I want to, in the end of the year, being like, I fixed my low buy year. I did it. And I don't think that my channels has been suffering from this low buy. That was such a big fear for me in the beginning when I was going into this low buy. I was like, what should I do? My channel is on so much first impressions and stuff, and I was like, I'm going to lose all my subscribers. That was a really big concern for me, but it has gone good. I hope that you are not so affected by this low buy. And yeah, I'm just glad that I'm still sticking to it. And for, as I said, in June, I haven't bought anything makeup related. Things I want to buy, I have made a video on it. I can leave it up here if I have any cards left, or it's down in the description. I'm waiting for the Oceanic palette from Ace Beauté to come to Beauty Bay. It will come, but maybe next year, because they are so slow. So I want to buy that one. I also going to buy a new concealer soon, because this is running so low. What more am I planning to buy? I think I will buy the Secret palette from Nabla. I have not decided it yet, but I think I will, because I have all their other palettes, so it feels like I want that one as well. Other than that, I don't have any makeup purchase planned yet. So yeah, it feels good. And I don't know what more to say. Actually, I have nothing more to say about this matter. So yeah, I really hope you liked this video, and if you are also doing a low buy or a no buy this year, please tell me and tell me how it's going for you. It's always fun to chat with you, and I really hope you like this video. And if you want me to do any more videos regarding my low buy, I don't know what that would be, but please tell me, and I will, in the end of this year, if I succeed or if I'm not succeed, I will do the same video. Either way, I will do like a big collective haul, all the makeup things I have bought in 2019. And yeah, one other thing I can also tell you, with Menagerie Cosmetics, I haven't got that palette yet. I talked about it a little bit in my last update, or my first update, that I bought a lipstick and the Whale Song palette, but then it was delays on delays on delays, and I really feel for the company, for Menagerie, and they offered two liquid lipsticks, so I got two more liquid lipsticks. I haven't count them as an item, because I think of that as a gift. So I just want to say that. So yeah, I really hope you liked this video, and yeah, please tell me if you are doing a low buy or a no buy. We can chat in the comments, and if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do, so you don't miss any of my videos, and I will see you in the next one. Bye! I just remember, I maybe should talk a little bit about my feelings about this. I feel good, as I said, and I don't have that urge to buy something. You know, when you see something new and you like, I want to have it now. I don't feel that, and that feels good. And now I can watch reviews of things or first impressions of things and be intrigued, but not that intrigued that I immediately want to buy it. And that feels so good, and I have so much more time to focus on the makeup that I already have, which was one of the reasons why I went on this low buy. So it feels good. If you don't have a healthy relationship with makeup, either your collection or things you buy, I think that you should maybe try to have a low buy, maybe not a whole year, but maybe like 1 or 2 months. It takes a little while to let go of that urge, and that feels good. I don't know why I talk like that, because it sounds like I'm a life coach or anything. I am not. I just wanted to share my feelings, my thoughts on this, because you are following me on this low buy journey this year. So yeah, now I am finished. Now we can end this.